you. Can I ever worship you enough? Can I ever thank you enough? My Lord and my God, Dikatria, Kukari Katas, Kibroku Mokuria, Karababa. Holy Ghost, Holy Ghost, Mashibaya, Mori Mababa, Mori Gana. Lord, we are here again, Mashamalata, Ribababa, Kuri Mababa. Our expectation is very high. That which is your will, that is what, O God, we expect, O God. Let me pray in the name of Jesus. Thank you, O God, for this afternoon section. Be thou exalted, be thou magnified. In Jesus' name. Amen. Church, be seated. Praise the Lord. Praise the Lord. How many of us enjoyed our food in the morning section? Was it good? Did you learn something? God bless you, church. You see, this month is our month of hearing from Jehovah. Month of hearing from the Lord. I do not want to go back to it. That's why we have all our messages on YouTube. So that the previous ones, you know, could be viewed. So that you continue. It has been a wonderful time. It has been a season of empowerment because on Wednesday when our pastor was teaching during the Bible study, he made it very clear that the power we need is revelation. It's when we discover and recover. It's also understanding what God has endured on us. Praise the Lord. Mm-hmm. I will endure you with power. Praise the Lord. The gifts that God has given to us. So, I did this position. I've been able to tackle, to explain to us the difference between hearing from God and hearing from the Holy Spirit. And I was able to explain it, make it very clear that there is nothing like hearing from the Holy Spirit. But there is something like hearing from God. Why? God is the one in heaven. And God is communicating with His Spirit in us. If then you are hearing from the Holy Spirit, it means you are not dead. It means you are not yet crucified with Christ. So you are still fighting with the Holy Ghost in your body. Holy Ghost, get out. I hear from the Holy Spirit. Holy Ghost, get out. You are fighting. It's supposed to be His house. Paul said, I'm crucified with Christ. It's no more me that lives. It's not Christ that lives in me. And that Holy Ghost is the kingdom of God. Why God is in the kingdom of heaven. Does that make sense? Now, in the only place in the Bible where they talked about and Holy Ghost said we should release Paul and Barnabas, I showed you what happened. They came together as a church. They fasted. And after they have fasted, read it very well. In Acts chapter 13, we are not going there, 1 to 2. And after they have fasted, somebody stood up, which if Australia allowed God to do what He wants to do, Australia will start seeing that kind of gift. As they were praying, all of them, they were ministers. One of them was jacked up by the Holy Spirit. And he said, separate me, Paul and Barnabas, for the work I have. You have been praying and asking me. That's how he speaks. You have been praying and asking me the next move of the church. Separate me. One of them stood up. He didn't say, Holy Ghost, Holy Ghost. He said, you just stood up after the prayer. He said, you have been praying for a long time. Now this is my answer. This is what I want you to do. Separate me with Paul and Barnabas. And the Bible says, after that person ministered by the power of the Holy Ghost, they still continued in fasting and prayer, if you read that verse. Which means, when they heard that person speak by the power of the Holy Ghost, they did not just accept it, they still prayed for confirmation. And when they prayed, they now said, when they were now writing to the church, they say, while we were praying, the Holy Ghost spoke. Now, that Holy Ghost that spoke did not speak, Holy Ghost told me, Holy Ghost told me. Somebody just stood up and said, I've come, I'm here to answer your prayers. Separate me from them, that's the next step. Thank God you started seeing the fly. That was, it was disturbing me. Church, are you getting what I'm saying? But don't worry, it's because of the weather. Because of somebody are coming out. So, hearing from God is real. But the message where I believe that Jehovah wants me to bring his position to is, we don't need to wait until we hear from God audibly. Neither do we need to wait until maybe it is revealed unto us through, you know, some, there are some people when God want to show them something, something will come out and they start reading. Their eyes will be open and they start seeing it. We don't need to wait for that. It's a gift, no doubt. It happens, no doubt. But there is this very easy way to hear from God. But it has process. You have to be clear. And you have to be real. Are you getting that? You have to be, and you have to be real. And with meekness, humble yourself with meekness, though you know everything, then you can hear from God. And this morning, I decided to come from another angle to explain it more. And I shared about that. I started with the topic, which is what we are continuing with, the evidences of hearing from God. And in the morning I was able to give one of the evidences. One of the evidences. What was that? Becoming a sheep. If you are in a church and you're not yet a sheep, if you read the Bible in Luke chapter 15, God was talking about the parable of the lost. Not only the lost son, it started with lost sheep. These are the three levels of growth in Christianity. You becoming a sheep. And when you become a sheep, what's the next level? Becoming a corn. When you are a sheep, you are still alive a bit. But when you are gone, you are dead. And when they came to Jesus and said, are we supposed to pay tax? Are we supposed to do this? Are we supposed to do this? He said, can I see the corn? He said, whose face is on the corn? They say, Caesar. He said, that's Caesar's coin. Give to Caesar the coin that belongs to him. Give me the coin that belongs to him. So they come until the time will come when you become a sheep, the next level will be your coin, all your face, everything that will be on you, coin, you are dead. The only picture that will be there, the only thing that will be there will be the face of Jesus. But God doesn't want us to settle on that level. God wants us to have dominion, to be blessed, to bear fruit. Then he now moves us to the level of a son, the lost son. He was showing, the prodigal son. He was showing us this level. And when you are, you see, sheep and corn, when they got lost, the master began to look for them. But when the son got lost, the master did not. The master did not. God did not go looking for the son.
And you know, God loved it so much that the son said, give me what belongs to me. That the son knew that what the father has is his own. Wasn't that prodigal? It wasn't that prodigal, mean using what you have, not wastefully. If he has used it wisely, would have been something great. So what I'm trying to say in effect is that becoming a sheep is one of the evidence that you have started hearing from God. Because the word you have had now will not transform you from a goat to a sheep. If you are outside the camp, you are a goat. If you are in the fold, you are a sheep. If you come into the fold and you are a goat, within short time you become a sheep. Praise the Lord.
Amen.
What is the next thing, the next evidence that proves that you have started hearing from the Lord? Psalms 24 verse 15. This is one of the most beautiful part of it. The first evidence is becoming a sheep, a disciple, becoming somebody that have given himself. You know, do you know when you become a sheep, even in punishment, you are still the best in the heart of God. The Bible says, you know, he carries them here when you make mistakes, sheep. And the reason why he carries them is because that sheep is straying away. And at a time when he does it so many times, he will just use something and hit the baby. And when that sheep cannot walk again, he will carry. The shepherd dies for the sheep. So that is it. Then when you come to that level, when you start experiencing this one, are you there, Psalms? Are you there?
24.
Verse 15, 1-5.
24:15?
Yes.
There's no 15. Yeah,
it's just 10. Is it 25:14? Is it 24? Psalms. 24, there's no 15.
No.
Oh, okay, try 25:14.
The secret of the Lord is
that is it.
The fear him.
That is it. What did he say?
The secret of the Lord is with him that fear him.
Now, do you see the next thing will be this? God will start revealing to you the secrets. The secrets concerning his purpose about you. That's the sign, that's the evidence. It's one of the evidences that you're hearing from God. Pastor Joseph, what do you mean? When I became a sheep and humbled myself, 1993, 94, 95, 96, God saw my heart. And God started revealing the secret of church upon mission to me. He started with, I entered into covenant with our bishop, Ernest in the house. I said, God, thank God, I'm a prayer warrior. So what do you want me to do? And our bishop, Ernest in the house, pleased me. My son did great work. But when he handed over the baton to the next generation, they weren't interested to run with a vision. They were now enjoying, this belongs to me. This, he's a mini man. He's my mentor. He's this, he's that. And God came to dream and said, they are not doing what they are supposed to do. You see, the secret of the Lord, 25:14 of Psalms, is with those that Jehovah will start revealing his secret. I'm telling you, if you humble yourself very well about this church, you will see one day you come here and say, Pastor, I saw the 20,000 seater church. I've seen it. I was in it. Now, you know, when I say all these things, It wasn't as if that I just, it was like dream, you know, God handling what he wants us to achieve more if we can do more for him in our hearts. Was it 2001, 2002? I had a dream. If you see, my father had already built it. When I came to Malaysia, I had a dream. If you see skyscraper that God used me to build. When I came to Australia, I had a dream too. I had a Westcott. All the building, every parastatal of the government, they were all finished 80%. And had a Westcott say, it is your turn to finish it. But when I spoke with my friend, Glenn said, let's sell it. I said, really, sell it? I said, in the dream. I said, Glenn, okay, go and look for people that will buy it. But before he came back, I changed my mind. I said, I'm not going to sell it. I'm going to build it. Mm. When I was in Nigeria, God showed me, if you see the kind of house my dad built in my village, in my community, is bigger than the academy I want to build. So these were the things that pointed. If you see me having the saying that I'm going to build 20,000 seat church, I already had a dream about it. I'm not just a braggadocio or bragging about it. I've seen it. It's God pointed it to me. Secrets. I came to Malaysia. Skyscraper, it has already been finished just for me to plaster it. I was building it. I came to Australia. Harry Westcott gave me, he said, this bush, some, he has already finished 80% just for me to add the 20%. And these were like Health Department of Australia, Sports Department of Australia, every facet of government department. But there were small snakes inside. But what I was doing, the snakes were too small. I was just chopping it with what I had. And my friend Glenn was there. I said, Glenn, so what are we going to do? Glenn said, let's sell it. I said, really? Sell it. I said, go and get buyers. He really came back with buyers. But before the buyers came, I said, I'm not going to sell it. This is God's vision. I'm not selling it. I have to finish it. The secret of the God started revealing secrets. Like Abishop Margaret Bessie the host. I was among the people that hated to see a woman be a leader of a church. But when I looked at Bishop Asine Dohasen serving, and how great God was using him, then I began to pray. I said, God, convince me. I don't want to be in this church and be angry with a woman. God gave me a revelation. He said, this is the end time. I'm using her as a sign to prove that this is the season of Eve multiplying anointing before the holidays. And when I got the dream, Bishop Edoasen was there in the dream. He was the one that kind of announced the new season. So I went to him. I said, that was 2003. I said, Daddy, go to dream. Actually, God was telling me about mama. But God showed me. He said, my job is to leave Nigeria. Go to the world. Because the people that I gathered, both white people, everybody, God said, it is you that will go and bring sheep, disciples, and Abishop will look after them. I said, but you were the one, like the person in charge. I said, Daddy, God has blessed you. He has blessed you. He said, he's going to bless me because of you. You know what Bishop Edoasen said? He said, you can't be finished. I said, yes. He said, you can't be hearing the kind of thing. Yeah? I said, Daddy, this one is real. You will see it come to pass. God is blessing me because of you. What is happening now is now a reality. God will start revealing secrets. Nation. Look at what is happening in my country. 10th of June 2015. I wasn't praying for Nigeria. I wasn't praying. I was praying because we have found out that my wife is now having in her womb twins. I said, God, Why have you given us these dreams? I was praying earnestly to know the purpose, goal, so that I will know how to channel them to you know. And lo and behold, I had a dream because God likes hiding things. Lo and behold, it was not Nigeria. Dramatically, a young boy like David just became the president. He was an Igbo man. From Ben, where this Nnamdi is, whatever his name, is old Ben. Dramatically. There was nobody to challenge him. And he said, when he was giving his speech, just like he said, God. And when I was about, he was so awesome. It became a new country. You know, a dream is you need to understand. When I was leaving, he called me. He said, Genesis 18 verse 10. Huh? I woke up immediately. I picked my hand. I woke my wife up. I said, God has told me something clear, specific. Genesis 18, let's read it. Genesis 18, no, it's not, don't worry about it. And it says, by this time next year, according to the time of life, Sarah shall be with the son. Do you know when I read that, even especially the dream was complicated, I said, sweetheart, maybe you're carrying a son. Either you're carrying a son or these children, because the Lord of God is with talent. Or these children, they will do